Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on updating dimension metadata using flat files in Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud. You can add or update dimension metadata in a new or existing application by importing flat files. You can also edit dimensions manually in Dimension Management. In this tutorial, we'll concentrate on importing flat files. We're working with the existing sample application, but import procedures are the same for new applications. You can view your dimension details on the Dimension Management screen. Here, you can see the list of dimensions, how many members in each dimension, and when it was last updated. Notice that the product dimension has 11 members. You can update a dimension by preparing a flat file that contains all the dimension metadata. Each dimension you update requires a separate flat file, and each flat file must completely define the dimension. Dimension flat files are text files that contain the following rows. The first row is a header record that specifies the order of dimension and member properties. The second row is a dimension data record with values for the properties. The third through last rows are individual member data records with values for the properties. I'll add a line to the file for a new product. Also, let's say the bike trailer product was accidentally left out of this flat file. Remember, the file must completely define the dimension, so you'll see how the system deals with missing information. You can update dimensions from flat files stored in the application inbox on the server or on your local drive. The File Explorer tab on the application screen gives you an easy interface to manage any files uploaded to or exported from the server. Exported files are stored in the Outbox folder, and imported files are stored in the inbox. I'll upload my flat file to the server. Now let's see our dimension update options on the application tab. In the Actions menu, I'll select Update Dimensions. Notice that you have the option to run a pre-update analysis on your flat file. Validate Dimensions checks if your dimension hierarchy is valid, and Impact Analysis lists the impact of the potential dimension update on your existing allocations and analyses. As a best practice, you should run a pre-update analysis before you update dimensions. Because I'm updating an existing dimension, I'll select Impact Analysis. Notice that Validate Dimensions is selected automatically. I'll add a row to the file list and select a file. Notice that the product file is available to select from the server. You can add files to update multiple dimensions at the same time. Now that the file is selected, I'll run the pre-update analysis. You get a message telling you to check the job library. Let's check on the job status. In the job row, you can click the actions icon and select Inspect to see details of your analysis results. In this example, my pre-update analysis resulted in impacts. I'll click the link to see impact details. The impact analysis starts by showing how many members were added and deleted, and if any members changed from level 0 to non-level 0. In this example, you can see the product I added. You can also see the deletion caused by the missing product. If the dimension changes affected any rules for a POV, those impacts show next. No rules are affected in this example. Finally, the analysis shows the impact on your analytics. Scrolling down, I see that the deleted member has an impact on my existing analysis views. You can optionally save the analysis details to a file. I'll return to my flat file and fix the error, then run the pre-update analysis again. This time, my impact analysis shows no deleted members. The report also shows no impact on existing rules and analytics. After running a pre-update analysis, you can update your dimension. This time, in the Update options, I'll select Update Dimensions. I'll upload my modified file from my local drive. Let's check the job status in the job library. Notice that the dimension update was a success. The job details list the update file name, but don't include specific update information. You can check your dimension for changes in Dimension Management. Notice that product now has 12 members, not 11. I can see that the new product was added to the dimension. You can also download the dimension details as a CSV file. For more information on editing dimensions manually, see our tutorial on dimension management. In this tutorial, you saw how to update dimension metadata using flat files in Oracle Profitability and Cost Management Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.